Morning Zoo.
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 I'm Alex Selig. In American history, no time period was more prosperous than the Roaring Twenties. However, sometimes individuals chose to gain prosperity by illegal means. This special report takes you into organized crime of the Roaring Twenties.
By F. Scott Fitzgerald took a look at such gangsters as Wolfsheim. Wolfsheim was a bootlegger, a gambler, someone in an underground crime ring. This is representative of the Roaring Twenties, when people such as Al Capone dominated the underground crime rings in Chicago, and there are also gangsters in the Northeast, in New York, and Boston. Let me give you an inside look into the speakeasies and gambling rings of the 1920s.
Follow me to the transport room, where we can beam ourselves to the Roaring Twenties and observe the crime rings firsthand. Let's go. Now, where's that transporter room? Let's see. Oh, wrong room. Once again. Ah, here we are. Here we are. Ah, yes, the transporter. Now, it's time to step back and experience the magic of the Roaring Twenties. The transporter sounds. That's not the transporter room at all, now is it? Okay, onward. I forgot they moved the transporter room down here. I mean over here. Right, yeah. Oh, now I remember. So folks, get ready to take a step back into the Roaring Twenties. The most infamous of these gatherings in the 20s was the speakeasy. These underground bars were the site of illegal drinking and gambling, and it was often the meeting places of big mob bosses. Here we are. Let's see what we have to do to get in. I think I might have something to pay along.
I hope I'm in the right place. Who's this guy? He looks sketchy. Hey, how's it going? Say hello to my friend, George Washington. It's a $1 bill. Come on.
I'm sorry, sir. That's not enough.
Fine. God.
Good evening, sir.
Let's try this one more time. I'm gonna come back packing. That's right. This guy's still here. Yeah, baby, it's me, and check it out. Hello. Say hello to my friend, Abe Lincoln. I guess I warmed his palms enough. Man, it's a party in here. What? He looks just like me. Who is that? That must be my uncle. He was the greatest pool shark of the 1920s. Man, he sure looks like me. Oh, he's laying it all on the line on one shot. Here he goes. I mean, maybe that wasn't my uncle, but you know. These guys sure know how to party in the 20s. Look at him. Just relaxing, talking, maybe playing a poker game later. Looks like they have some illegal alcohol on the table. Man, they sure were big spenders, too. Look at that money on the poker. Oh, turning one back for the team. That's right. Do my family right. Hey, cheers, right? Cheers. It's all good in the 20s.
That was a lot of fun. But, sometimes the speakeasies got a little more intense than that.
Sometimes people wouldn't even make it to the speakeasy. Gangsters such as Al Capone were notorious for murdering those who crossed them.
Last night's business deal wasn't good.
Unfortunately, my uncle was one of those people.
Whoa. I swear I'll get it. I'll get him his money. I'll get him his money. Please, please.
Not my family's finest hour.
Other times, speakeasy owners had to employ clever tactics to evade the police.
Yes, sir? What can we do for you?
What's going on in here now, boys?
Nothing. What you want?
Now, this ain't no speakeasy now, is it? Oh,
please, sir. I am a smart businessman like myself, as I run no illegally drinking or gambling places here in this fine city of Chicago.
Well then, what's going on in here?
Why, sir, can't you see? This is a pet shop.
A pet shop?
Yes, we have nice kittens here. Would you like... I tell you what, I believe that you look like a cop. I will give you a free kitten. Would you like a free kitten?
Kittens, huh?
Yeah, a kitten, that's right.
Well, you boys enjoy yourself tonight.
You got it, sir. Enjoy that little kitten there.
Darn it.
Now that just sucked.
Being a superb athlete, I'm a great fan of professional sports. But I tell you what can ruin sports for me is cheating. In The Great Gatsby, Wolfsheim pays off the Chicago White Sox to lose the 1919 World Series, an actual event. The Chicago White Sox, otherwise known as the Black Sox for their scandalous nature, were paid off to lose to the Cincinnati Reds in the World Series. Man, cheating in baseball just don't miss. Ball one, right?
Cincinnati Reds defeat the White Sox in 8 games.
Yes, it's true, folks. Your beloved 1919 White Sox were defeated by the Cincinnati Reds in 8 games, 5-3. But could this man be solely responsible for the downfall of this dominant franchise?
What?
While it may seem hard to believe that 8 professional athletes would be involved in such an intricate gambling circle, 8 players from the White Sox have reportedly been involved with dealings with a shady character known only by the name of Wolfsheim. Wolfsheim, a convicted bootlegger and gambler, has been seen making deals with the players before, after, and between the games at parties.
If you are fixing the series, you will hit the first batter.
The posh story being circulated today is that the ace for the Chicago White Sox was told by Wolfsheim that if he and the team agreed to throw the series, that he would hit the first batter of the ballgame. It is this reporter's humble opinion that no baseball player would subject themselves to the lowness of bootleggers. Oh, well, he just hit him. Apparently Mr. Wolfsheim is thrilled. Well, maybe it was just that pitcher. I'm sure our trusty third baseman never agreed to that. Oh, he just missed a routine ground ball. That's not good. Well, let's... Oh, no, he's missed another pop fly. Well, maybe he is in on it, too. Oh, my. In a unique turn of events, the White Sox also saw Mr. Wolfsheim rush onto the field and attack the players a couple times. Those may seem unorthodox. The style was not seen by the umpires, as apparently they were busy counting the money they had just received. Oh, one man I know would never subject himself to gambles was Shoeless Joe Jackson. Shoeless Joe, look at him up at the plate. The pitch. Oh, it's a deep fly ball to left. That ball is going, going, gone. A three-run shot. Oh, Shoeless Joe. Shoeless Joe has been shot in the back by a sniper rifle. Oh, my. While many may believe that something fishy is going on here, is the opinion of this reporter that there was no deal involved with these players, and that there's no way should they be banned from the sport of baseball. These players are just victims of circumstance and the fact that maybe they just had an off series, you know, just playing a couple bad games, making some errors, you know, challenging the other player to a fight every once in a while. You never know how it goes. All I can say to the White Sox now is, perk up, boys. There's always next year. But the only thing I have to say to Mr. Wolfsheim is, you should be ashamed of yourself, mister. This is Zach Daw reminding you to always keep your eye on the ball.
Time for another night of fun at a speakeasy.
I decided to sit down to a game of poker with two famous bootleggers. Here's the deal. We're playing No Limit Hold'em.
I whooped a northern eye in some poker.
Don't get too excited over there.
I'm sorry, sir. You have a flush, but you are out of the game.
Well, it did start out kind of bad. I did get a little overexcited.
All right. I got the lady folks table.
Yeah, where'd I get that guy?
Hey, we don't need that.
Glad I didn't shoot that guy. I kind of liked him. Well, the game continues. My luck didn't get any better.
And the river?
And I lost another hand. I was all in here. I was a little upset. But I had suspicions that this guy was cheating. Look at that sneaky face. And we turn our cards.
I believe it's time for one of us to go.
And he throws it all in.
Don't hurt yourself over there.
What's the plan?
I decided to call. I thought I had a better hand than he did. Look at that stone cold face. Sir? Such a great poker player.
I need to see him.
I have no doubt about my abilities. That dirty scoundrel. I knew something was fishy when he had those aces.
Three of a kind aces.
He had to have cheated. There's no way.
Yeah, I got a little out of hand here.
My good sir, from where I'm from, we do not cheat.
Oh, there's the ace. That was right up his sleeve.
So what was that?
Where did that come from?
That was just a gift from my good man.
Maybe this wasn't justified.
Right. I don't want to.
Maybe it was. I didn't really like him.
Sir, and what kind of game are you running?
I'm not doing anything.
That dude was a little fishy too. Well, I guess it's time to grab the money and run.
Money
and you,
money.
It's right here, sweet cheeks.
What did you do, Jack? It's out.
What did the gun say to the face? What? He needed a few extra ones.
God. Just take my money and roll.
And I got out of there as fast as I could.
What I learned just now is that you don't cross the boss. And if you do, you may pay with your life.
Oh man, I gotta get this blood washed off somewhere.
I hope you learned a lot about the 1920s. But it's time for me to wash up and get to the present. That sure was, how do you say, exciting. Well,
I enjoyed the Roaring Twenties, but I'd rather enjoy it from the distance of a great book such as The Great Gatsby. This is Alex Selig, signing out.
That's true.